Hello, welcome in chemical education. In this video, we are observing that there's some experimental part. The first part is critical solution temperature. The temperature at which two immiscible solvents form homogeneous solution at particular temperature and at a particular proportion is called as the critical solution temperature. See here, this is a hard glass tube, and in this hard glass tube, suppose we are adding one first solvent, and when we are adding the another solvent in which is immiscible with each other, it forms the two layers. In this hard glass tube, we observe the two layers. Now, when we heat it, this solution or this mixture, then it is observed that after certain time, by reaching certain temperature, these two solvents get mixed together to form the homogeneous solution. Now, this temperature is called as critical solution temperature. Here, the concentration of both solvents are also important. It changes the critical solution temperature. Now, for this experiment, we require the apparatus like beaker. This is for use for water bath. We have to heat the solution. Or sand bath, burner, burette to measure the solution or water or salt solution to add into the hard glass tube, thermometer to measure the temperature, measuring cylinder to measure the phenol. This is a stirrer to stir the solution continuously, hard glass tube, cork and tripod stand. Now, phenol. In the first experiment, we will see the phenol water system and to find out the critical solution temperature. And in second experiment, we have to observe that when we, the study of after addition of salt into the solution or water, what happened on the critical solution temperature. Okay, in the first part, we are observing that these are making the three sets of the amount of phenol with the different amount of quantity of the water. Now, in the first set, we have to take the 10 gram of phenol. That is, we have to measure the 9.5 ml of phenol by using the measuring cylinder. And we have to add the 6 ml of water. Now, this 10 gram of phenol, we have to first keep into the hard glass tube. Then we have to add the 6 ml of water into the hard glass tube. And the percentage of phenol where the 62.5% and 37.5% of water. Now, this is the two solvents we are adding into the hard glass tube. Okay, is it clear? If you have any doubt, you can ask at any time.
Yes, sir. How to measure phenol?
Yes, we know that phenol is a toxic chemical. And when we are taking the phenol in the bottle, it is in crystalline in nature. Then, to measure the 9.5 ml of phenol, we have to transfer this crystal into the molten form, and therefore we have to keep this crystal or bottle into the water bath to warm up. And after warming, the phenol get converted, phenol crystals get molten, and that molten phenol we can measure 9.5 ml with the help of measuring cylinder. The care should be taken that the phenol should not be touch with your skin, because it is a harmful to your skin, and therefore we have to measure by taking the care 9.5 ml of phenol into the hard glass tube. Then we have to add the 6 ml of water, and the proportion is like this. And then this hard glass tube, by keeping the stirrer and thermometer, we have to heat it into the water bath with constant stirring, and at certain position or certain temperature, these two solvents, phenol and water, get mixed together to get the clear solution. And then we have to measure the temperature, and we have to record the temperature. In this way, the first set, in the second set, what happened? The 10 ml of phenol, 10 gram of phenol, 8 ml of water. Means already in the first set, we are adding the 6 ml of water. We have to add just only 2 ml of water from the burette in the same hard glass tube, then it gives the combination of 9.5 ml of phenol and 8 ml of water. and therefore the proportion is 55.6% of phenol and 44.44% of water. The same procedure we have to do, that is, we have to heat this solution mixture into water bath by constant stirring, and at a particular temperature they get miscible with each other. Then we have to measure the temperature and we can record. In another way, the recording of the temperature, first we have to record the temperature T1 as formation of the homogeneous solution, and after cooling, slowly cooling, when the solution again forms the two layers or give the whatever the solution, they get separate from one another to get the turbidity to the solution. That temperature also measure as a T2, and you can take the average of T1 and T2, and we can write here as a temperature. Okay, in this way we have to use first set, then second set, third set. In this way we can measure the take the solution mixture, and we have to measure the temperature. If you have any doubt, again you can ask the question.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Do we have to measure phenol in every set?
Yes. See here, this is a very good question, because in the first set we have to measure the 9.5 ml phenol for first set. We have to add the 6 ml of water first, then we are adding the 2 ml of in the same solution, then we are adding the 4 ml water, then we are adding the 3 ml of water, and we have to measure the temperature. After completion of this, then we have to take the second set. Then we have to measure exactly the 4.8 ml of phenol, that is a 5 gram of phenol, 10 ml of water in that, in the first. Then we have to add the 5 ml of water in the same set. Then we have to measure the temperature of the homogeneous phase. Then we have to select the third stage, third step, that is 2.5 gram of phenol, that is 2.4 ml of phenol, in which we have to add the 15 ml of water, then measure the temperature. Then we have to add the 5 ml, further we have to add the 5 ml. In this way, for three sets, we have to take the three set three times. Okay, in this way we have to measure the temperature for the homogeneity. Okay, is it clear now? Yes. Okay, now in the apparatus, in the when we are starting the experiment, we are adding here the water, and then we are adding the phenol. It forms the two layers, and we have to keep this water bath on the tripod stand, and we have to heat it. We have to start the heating. At that time, what happened? We have to stir this solution constantly. After a certain time, what happened? We observed that there is a turbidity observed, because these solutions are mixed by constant stirring. And after a certain time, when it reaches to the critical solution temperature, then it forms the clear solution. We observe that here it forms the clear solution. After forming the clear solution, we have to measure the temperature and we have to record the temperature. In this way, for every time we have to measure the temperature when the these two solvents get miscible with each other or clear solution. Okay, in this way we have to measure this. For first set, we observed that the 48 degree Celsius temperature for this combination, 55 degree Celsius temperature for this combination, 60 degree Celsius for this combination. In this way, for each combination where the phenol percentage is initially it was maximum, then we are decreasing the percentage of the phenol and we are increasing the water. It is observed that at a particular temperature, at maximum temperature is observed, it is a 65, then 68 degree Celsius, at which the combination of the phenol and water is exactly the miscible, at this is the higher temperature. Okay, and this is the critical solution temperature of phenol water system. In the second set of this experiment, this is the first set. In the second set, before that we are observing that from this data we are plotting the graph, and from the graph we have to calculate the critical solution temperature. Here we have to plot the graph, mixing temperature on the this axis and percentage of phenol on this axis, and it is observed that after plotting the graph, it is observed that the graph nature is like a bell shape, and at the apex of this bell or top of the bell, this is the where this is the temperature at which the maximum temperature where the two solutions at a proper proportion, they mix together, and this percentage is the percentage of the phenol with the water, we get the critical solution temperature. In the same way, the second part, where instead of water, we have to take the salt solution, because we have to study after addition of the salt, what happened on the critical solution temperature. Same experiment we have to do. The same sets are there. Instead of water, we have to take the salt solution. And this is observed that in the experiment, the temperature is observed that the temperature like 50 degrees Celsius, 57 degrees Celsius, 63 degrees Celsius, and the maximum temperature, slightly the temperature of the critical solution temperature is increased. And from that, we can plot the graph. The both graphs are on the same graph paper, and it is observed that the after addition of the salt, it is observed that the slightly the critical solution temperature is increases from T1 to T2. Now, in the result, we have to write the critical solution temperature of phenol water system is a 68 degrees Celsius, and critical solution temperature from the for the phenol salt solution system, it is a T2 equal to 74 degrees Celsius. The difference is because of the effect of addition of salt, that by 6 degrees Celsius temperature, the critical solution temperature is increased. Now, from that increase in the critical solution temperature, the change in the critical temperature are found to be a linearly proportional to the percentage of the salt, and hence salt is more soluble in one of the solvent, that is in water. And therefore, critical solution temperature affects, that is increases, if the impurity is added. Okay. Thank you.